Sup, peeps? How's it going? Welcome aboard Cessna Skyhawk. November 808 Sierra Whiskey with the G1000. We are on episode number 4 of our journey from Portland, Oregon to Portland, Maine. On this route, we are flying from Idaho Falls. We're gonna stop in Jackson Hole really quick. Probably just do a touch and go there, and then continue east to Dubois Municipal. Never been there before, so that'll be cool. And just trekking farther east. VJ, what's up? Good to see you. Welcome. We're gonna be cruising at 11,500. Actually, let me pull up Sky Vector and show you guys what the plan is. We're currently on the ground here in Idaho Falls. We're going to depart VFR to the east. Actually, what the heck is the weather here? Let me see what runway we're going to plan. Idaho Falls is reporting wind 2107 knots, so probably runway... Probably 2-1 would be the shortest taxi, I'm assuming. So that's what we'll do. Simple as that. And then, let's see. Jackson Hole is right along our route. And we're just going to wing it. And I believe they're landing north in Jackson Hole, so... We'll just do a quick touch and go, most likely, and then continue eastbound to our final destination of Dubois Municipal, which is looks like it's nestled in some this mountain range, so that'll be interesting at 7,299 feet. It should take us about 50 minutes, is what Sky Vector is saying. About 11,500, but with a stop in Jackson Hole, probably add, I don't know, 10 or 15 minutes to that. That'll be about an hour. Alright, that's it. That's the plan. Just gonna wing it. And we have some VFR weather, so hopefully it won't be... actually, Jacksonville might not be so perfect. What was the weather in Jacksonville? Jacksonville, why do I keep saying Jacksonville? Jackson Hole. Wind is 1204 knots, 6 mile visibility, light snow, clear skies. How does that make any sense? Light snow, where's the snow coming from? If it's clear skies. Okay, temperatures minus 9, dew point minus 16, altimeter 3011. Alright, so we'll see what it looks like when we get there. Idaho, 2010, mile visibility, clear skies, altimeter 3022. Alright, let's jump into the left seat here, and we'll get this bird ready to go. VJ, what's up? Welcome. Good to see ya. Alright, so I actually have I found a better checklist for the Cessna here, so we're gonna run through this. We'll assume the aircraft is airworthy. We'll skip... first part of this checklist. Go to before start engine, pre-flight inspection complete, seatbelts, doors. It is actually really cold outside, so we'll go ahead and close the doors. Okay. Doors, passenger briefing, circuit breakers, electrical equipment, avionics switch off, fuel selector both. Wait, hold on a second. I need to make sure that we have the right amount of fuel. Where am I trying to go? Not here. We need to go to here. Customize. Weight balance. Set. Total internal. What is it? 3 hours. Okay, yeah, that'll do the trick. More than enough. Avionics switch off, fuel selectors both, brakes set, throttle open a quarter of an inch, and then mixture control idle cutoff. Okay, that's cut off. Standby battery switch test, then arm. So it looks like the test got a green light. We'll go to arm. Where were we? Standby set. Engine indication system checked. Volts. Verify 24 volts minimum. On the E side, 24 and a half is indicating. M bus volts less than or equal to 1.5. So it's zero, so that's less than 1.5, so we're good. Battery SAMs, verify discharge, standby battery annunciator, propeller area clear, master switch on. Master switch beacon light on. Fuel pump as required. I guess I'll turn it on, I don't know. As required, mixture control if required, advance to full rich prime. Well, since we're our elevation is like 4,000 something feet here, I'm going to lean it a little bit. So I probably don't need it. Alright. Alright, where were we? Mixture control, I don't. Fuel pump off. Wait, what the hell? This doesn't make any sense. Master switch beacon, fuel pump as required, mixture control, idle cutoff. If required, advance to full rich prime. Idle cutoff, fuel pump off, magneto switch start. What? Alright. I'm gonna follow the instructions and see if it still works. So it says mixture. This doesn't make any sense. Fuel pump off. How is the engine gonna start? Magneto switch start. Wait a second, don't we need, Oh wait, never mind. Yeah, see, that's not gonna start. What the hell is this checklist? It's insane. I don't know, maybe this is a typo or something. It must be, because it literally says mixture control, if required, advance to full rich, and then immediately after that, it says mixture control, idle cutoff. Alright, whatever, I'm gonna do it my way. We're gonna get the fuel pump on, and we're gonna lean the mixture just a little bit. Alright, let's try this again. Start. Ah, we got a good start there. Okay. Start, where were we? Magneto switch start, mixture control advance after start. Oil pressure check. Oil pressure's in the green. Throttle 1000 RPM. Let's see if I can maximize more RPM if I lean it even more. Good there. 1000 RPM. Amps check positive charge. Looks like got a positive charge on both sides. Low volts enunciator. Avionics switch on. Avionics switch lights as required. Mixture as required. Blah blah blah. Alright, that's good for now. We gotta do our routing. Plug in some stuff in the GPS. Yeah, I guess we'll get our nav lights on, actually. Fuel pump can go off for now. Okay, let's do... Alright, bear with me, because I suck at the G1000. I'm just going to make this easy. I'm going to plug in and direct, because our final destination, so direct... directs, what is it, kilo, delta, uniform, where the F is U, Bravo. Activate. facing west, that makes sense. Scheduled descent. What's up? Good to see ya. Yeah, I know. Strange things are happening. Okay, so I think I'll leave it at that. Bring back, where'd that checklist go? Taxi, seatbelts, brakes, instruments. Oh yeah, we gotta set the altimeter and stuff. Where'd that weather go? Altimeter's 3022. Set standby as well. Alright, that looks good. Alright, let's taxi up to the runway. And we'll do our run up there. Check. Going to start streaming 737 in a few weeks. We'll be covering a lot on how to start up a cold jet. Oh, awesome. I will definitely try to tune into that. Let's just go right here. God, I hate taxiing the freaking Cessna. Alright, we need some speed, and then it'll turn. Hours, beautiful. This since I just became a simmer. This is default scenery for Idaho Falls in X-Wing 11. Oh, god damn it. Turn. For the love of God. X-Plane 11 has really pretty great default scenery. Using PMDG and P3D, although I do have Zeebo and X-Plane 2. Oh, okay, cool. Still has its issues though. Oh yeah, for sure. Oops. Yeah, I love PMDG too, but ever since I made the switch to X-Plane, I've been really enjoying the Zeebo. According to Flight Deck to Sim, it's actually pretty freaking good, pretty realistic as far as flying handling goes. Alright, here we go. I think this is runway 21. I guess runway 317 is right there. Well, whatever. Just go with, why is this not updated? This should be runway 21, I'm pretty sure. Oh, well, it's all good. Okay, oh yeah, before I forget, let's do our run-up. Where'd that checklist go? You're not flying around Texas? Well, we're doing this series from Portland, Oregon to Portland, Maine, trying to fly across the country in a Cessna. It's taken a long time. PMDG models the systems much better. Yeah, that's definitely true. But the Zeebo's getting better with every new version that comes out. I mean, I can't really say for sure because obviously I'm not a real world 737. I'm just going off of what a Flight Deck 2 sim says. Okay, so before takeoff, parking brake is set, pilot and passenger seat back, seats and seat belts, cabin door, flight controls. Flight controls, that's a good idea. Left, aileron left, right, elevator aft, forward, and rudder left, right, free and correct. Controls, flight instruments, PFD, altimeter is set, standby altimeter is set, altitude is set at 11,500 for VR cruise. Standby flight instruments. Good. Skid. Fuel quantity checked. Or wait, did I check that? Where's fuel quantity? We're in the green. Where did I put that? Flight is not running, but both fuel quantity indicators are in the yellow. Yeah, okay, so yeah, we're in the green. Mixture control rich. Mixture rich, fuel selector valve is set to both, autopilot, electric trim control, well, that trim is set for takeoff, electric trim control, throttle to 1800 RPM, I'll check the magnetos. Back to both. Check the right side. Back to both. Magnetos, vac indicator, engine indicators, ammeters, valve and enunciators. Things are in the green. We'll check idle. In a 7-3. Oh, from Portland, Oregon to Portland, Maine. Where were we? Mixture as required. Comm frequency set. Nav frequency set. Flight plan as desired. Transponder is over here. We're gonna squawk VFR and altitude reporting. Okay. What else? Yeah, our frequencies are set. We're on advisory. Are we? Yeah, we're on advisory 22.8. Strobe lights, landing lights. Alright, I'm gonna lean the, since we're at like almost 5,000 feet, I'm going to lean the mixture a little bit for takeoff. Here's our best performance. Alright, there. Okay. Landing lights, strobe lights, and we'll make an advisory call. See, what are we doing? Have you heard of the East? That's it, okay. Idaho Falls traffic, Cessna Skyhawk, November 8080 Whiskey. It's departing runway 21 VFR to the East, Idaho Falls. Alright, let's rock. Full throttle. Starts a turn out to the east. About 1,000 AGL now. Out, Idaho Falls. It's actually a nice day. So much better than when we flew in a few days ago. Okay, so let me bring this up. What do we do in the climb? Flaps are up, mixture as required, engine gauges checked, airspeed. So, 1,000 feet then. Okay, 75 to 85 knots. Trim is set. So, we'll just check our engine instruments here. Everything's in the green. Progress bar. There we So yeah, there's Jackson Hole right there. So there's this big, this huge ass mountain range right here. So we're gonna kind of come around this way, come up from the south. They're landing north, so we can just do a straight-in approach. Just do a touch and go real quick, and then we'll continue to the east. Cause I have some pretty awesome scenery for Jackson Hole. So be awesome for me farm with a bunch of ortho for winter ortho, in fact. So it's all gonna be snowy and stuff. It'll be perfect. All right, got 2,000 feet to go, and we'll level off at 11,500. God, it's so hard to tell the difference between a freaking 6 and a 5. I always think we're in like 50s or 60s or vice versa. This be flight level change. Assuming this stands for flight level change. Maybe it stands for flight control, I don't know. What's flight control mean? Jacksonville. Alright, we should have leveled off. Or we're about to level off 11,500. I would imagine we do that automatically. Yay. Thank you. Jacksonville and the GPS I can bring up. Because I might have a little fun and practice a instrument approach. The Cessna. Select approach. So we got some options for runway 1. There's a VOR approach. No ILS. There's a GPS. I don't know if I don't even know if we can do an RNP. I would imagine we could probably not do an RNP. Required navigation. I don't know if we have that or not. The abilities. Alright, what else is there? So not even know, it might not recognize Dubois. I mean, this one is kind of a small airport. Oh well, since that's not working, just get that out of the way. What's up, Nick? How's it going, dude? Cessna 172, make it 900 miles? I don't know. the range. Just look up. Just look it up. Yeah, the range of a. Let's see here, Cessna. 736 miles. So apparently, no, it cannot make it 900. Join you on the next leg. Aight, sounds good to me. We're gonna do the FNO tonight. Papa Roach, what's going on? Just thinking about getting an American in trucking later tonight or tomorrow. Oh, hell yeah, man. Yeah, you should have got it last week when it was on sale. But still. It's a pretty cool game. So, no, I was thinking about flying the 172 into the FNO, but then it would be a total shit show if I were to make a small plane into there. Yeah, I don't know how much the air traffic controllers would appreciate. Cessna coming in, because usually the FNO at San Juan is pretty damn busy, especially. Cessna G1000 in real life before, plus the library looks like that library that I've seen from John and Martha King. What? But that's cool. We've flown a Cessna G1000. I definitely have never flown a G1000 in real life. I really have no idea what I'm doing with this thing. has two at Riddle. That is awesome. It's at, I have no idea where that is, Frederick Regional Airport. 5 hours in that plane, the other 104 hours are all in the Warrior. No ice at all. Pretty serious on the comms. Well, what's so non-serious about saying 124.4, see ya. Call sign. That sounds appropriate to me. Yo, Ryan83B, what's up? If you want some crazy weather, head to DFW and say thunderstorms. Oh, really? Yeah, that's interesting. I'm in Abilene right now. The weather looks fine. Okay, I'm moving up. Unprofessional, why? King are the people who demoed FS 2004, and I think FSX. I have also seen their videos on YouTube teaching student pilots about engine fire and whatnot. Oh, I think I know who you're talking about. Rather be here than O'Hare or Milwaukee, where they get blizzard and snow from the same storm. Yeah, wow. If I get to go up on Sunday, I'll try it when going from tower to ground. Yeah, dude. Wind 7, see ya. It works, man, it works. Alright, we are getting closer, obviously, because the ortho's coming in. We gotta look at the... What was I gonna say? We gotta look at the... what is the airport elevation here? Sky Vecta. 6,450 feet. Valley, start our descent, and we're gonna make a straight in front of where we want. If we can, if we're not too high. Fleet of the King's Ground School. Nice. Is your hand hurting because of the turbulence, or do you have autopilot turned on? I have autopilot turned on. Guys, temperature minus 9, dew point minus 16, altimeter 3011. Jesus. Oh god, I'm not gonna be able to set the, because this turbulence is way too bad. Alright, hopefully once we get it down into this valley, the, turbulence will let up. I mean, it's the airport is reporting winds relatively calm, so. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and start descending. So let's reset the altitude to, I don't know, 160 or something. Wait, what is the airport elevation again? 65? I'll run that up to 6,500. So we'll set 7,500, yeah, but 1,000 feet above. So we'll set 75. There we go, perfect. And we'll start start turning toward the field. That's not it. Where is it? Heading over here. Yeehaw. That's why I see if there's any traffic I should need to know about. Nope, no traffic. So I'm gonna be that asshole that makes a straight in approach. Checklist go, see what else. Cruise descent, weather, power, mixture, trim, altimeters, set, briefing, passenger briefing, seatbelts, fuel selector, both, mixture as required, airspeed, flap, full flaps, 60 to 70 knots, flaps, set, land lights, blah blah blah. Okay. Say 6 miles or 5 miles? Okay, so that's 6 miles. Looking good. God, I wish X-Plane had seasons. Out. Jackson Hole traffic, Cessna Skyhawk, November 8080, Whiskey is about 5 miles to the south, straight in, runway 1. We'll do a touch and go and then depart VFR to the east, Jackson Hole. About to level off at 7500, so I'm gonna let it do that. autopilot off my aircraft. Up. Leg called? I can't remember. Is this the upwind or like the departure leg? Alright, actually, geez. We gotta plan this a little bit better. Alright, let's enter a right downwind really quickly, and then we're gonna depart the air to the loading up your sim. Alright, Nick. Where's your float? Oh, thank you, Papa Roach. Where's your windows float, Cessna? I don't know. Is it to Dubois Municipal? It'll be, from here, it's 44 miles. We'll be there in about 23 minutes. It's nestled up here in the mountains, so this is going to be interesting. We're going to have to get some altitude. Quickly now. Weather at Dubois Interior Municipal. Wind 290, 24 gusts, 29. Oh god. 10 mile visibility, clear skies. Temperature minus 8, dew point minus 2, 1. Altimeter 297. November 222, November Delta. Height. You're at the Jackson Hole. Oh, yeah, I see you.
sense.
Go direct, it looks like we'll be all clear of terrain. Runway 19, what do you mean? At Jackson Hole? We already left Jackson Hole. Wind 300, 22, gust 28, 10 mile visibility, clear skies, temperature minus 18 point, minus 22, ultimate reach under 9 or 8. Alright, we're about 20 miles out. We'll be there in about 12 minutes. Out of the northwest, so west there, so we're gonna land runway 28 in Dubois, so that means we're gonna have to circle around to the other side. Let's see here. 7,000. Okay, the field elevation is 7,299 feet, so 7,300 you would say. So we'll want to be 8,300 in the pattern. And we'll enter, it's a right pattern for runway 28. So we'll enter a right downwind for runway 28 since we're just coming from the west. And it'll be as simple as that. Thank you. took off. Alright, gonna cruise at 16. What type are you? You're in a... What does it say? It says no flight plan. Refresh. Oh yeah, you're just no flight plan, so I have no idea what type of aircraft you in. closer, about 11 miles out. Start our descent then. Found a path. Height. No ice. Who's there? There's the turbulence, of course. Oh yeah, altimeter here is 2 9 or 8. Make sure we have that. 9 or 8. Traffic, Cessna Skyhawk, November 8080 Whiskey, 5 miles to the west. We're gonna enter a right downwind runway 28 Dubois. Oh, I guess I should have set my altitudes, but whatever. I always forget that. Pattern altitude. Freaking hell, this turbulence sucks. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and take control of my aircraft. Yo, Deshaun, what's going on? Welcome, man. Oh, God. Oh, sheesh. Oh, man, we are a bit... I feel like we're, like, super high, but we're almost to the pattern altitude. Flaps. Alright, that was almost perfect. Dubois traffic Skyhawk 8080 Whiskey on a 2 mile final runway 28 Dubois. Alright, I think we'll just do a notch of flaps. That should be fine. Bouncy. Alright, I'll take it. I thought that was gonna be way worse. Wow, don't even have to brake. Find a parking spot. Oh, jeez. Hey, what's up, Jack? Wait, where the hell should we go? Alright, yeah, let's go this way. this is like an FBO, I guess. It's kind of like one. Maybe. Let's come park. Park it right here and call it good. Because I don't know, otherwise there's not really like parking spots per se, just these hangars. So yeah, this'll do. Alright, let me bring up the checklist. Or actually, let me look at the chat. It's been forever since I actually looked at the chat properly. 3D45. A little behind. Jack's here. Engine performance sucks as predicted. Yep. To higher altitudes. Thanks to Sean. Thanks to Jack. Doing good. Should be fun in San Juan tonight. I was thinking about going out of Fort Lauderdale with the 700. Yeah, I'm going to do something similar. I don't know if it'll do exactly Fort Lauderdale. Maybe. But we'll figure out to find we'll find a route. Where did that checklist... Where did I put you? There you are. Okay, so after landing, air, ignition light off. Wait, what? No, before landing. No, descent, securing brakes, throttle, idle. Switch bus off magnetos. Avionics. Magnetos. Off. Mixture. Cut off. Magneto's key out, electrical equipment off. Master switch off. Hold on, I already got that. Fuel selector left or right. Chocks control lock and tie down. Okay, cool. Welcome to Dubois Municipal. Oh, I totally forgot the beacon. The lights. yeah, well, welcome to Dubois Municipal, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the ride. That was pretty fun going into Jackson Hole with all that ortho. You can get my 800 to work, which totally you can't get it, or you can. What with the latest version? Alright, we're gonna disconnect and do some replays. Oh yeah, I forgot. Well, whatever, the transponders. It's already off. Disconnect. And beacon rewind. Can't get the 800. Stupid. Yeah, is that the with the latest version or what? Supposed to cut the mixture first? I don't know, I was just following the checklist. This whatever the internet checklist that I found. Do another flight. Yeah, we are gonna do another flight. We had the FNO is tonight, so we're gonna fly into San Juan. Downloaded it wrong. I forgot how to install it. No, that's not good. Oh, holy crap. Moose is raiding with a party of 35. Good lord. Kramer, what's up? Dane Flats, what's up? Yes, Moose, Mustafa, I bow down to you, sir. Thank you. Moose, you doing the FNO tonight? Hello, Wolf and Scotty to Hottie. What's going on, guys? Welcome. And Kramer, thanks for the follow. Much appreciated. To St. Lucia. From St. Lucia to San Juan. Where's St. Lucia? St. Lucia to St. Barth's. That'd be cool. Panama City is an option with Copa. Panama City, we will look at that. Foot. Yeah, that place is crazy. Yeah, we should fly there in some time. That would be a good challenge. Do one more replay, and then this stream is pretty much over. Back to Princess Juliana as well. Flew to Princess Juliana once. Once? Only once? Yeah, that's a cool little airport. Classic. Classic airport. St. Martin. Yes. Alright. It's over, ladies and gentlemen. that is the conclusion of this stream. I need to take a break, conserve my energy for tonight's events in San Juan. Full ATC, lots of traffic, so don't forget a towel, because things tend to get sweaty. Crashed into the mountain, and it was a stain on my ego. Oh my god. I wish I could have seen that. Yeah, see ya, Jack. Plays Wayne or Austin Powers? That's a trick question. Okay. Let me start the right outro music. So, thanks everybody for watching. I hope to see everybody at the event tonight. Until then, peace.
Wind shear.